Before we left to go make this recording in New York, Michael Jackson says, I'm going to be there.
Because he would have been dying to get together to see Sinatra in action on a recording session.
I just got here.
I'm glad, man.
I just stepped on the airport.
I'm glad. You're just in time, too, Smelly.
I wanted very much to come to this session because I felt it was a moment that I didn't want to miss. I may not get the chance to run into him again. So I took advantage of it, just thinking that I'd meet him now. It's like a dream come true.
It was astounding to see the two of them together because the real landmarks, I think, in real pop phenomena starts with Sinatra. And it's a 10-year phenomena, so it would be Sinatra and then Elvis Presley in the 50s and the Beatles in the 60s. The 70s, I think it was Star Wars, so that one was skipped. And in the 80s, it was Michael Jackson. And to see the... There's no more Presley and there's no more Beatles now. And so to see the beginning and the end so far of those two people together was just, it gave me goosebumps.
He was a lot of fun, you know. He wanted to play the vibes. I said, if you learn me how to do that spin you do, I'll learn you how to play the vibes.
And to see Lionel Hampton and Michael Jackson and Frank Sinatra in the same studio was really, you know, it pulls it all together.
You know, I was just cooling it in front, but it's so nice and quiet, I ought to do it an octave lower like I did it. The few bars in front. Sure.
I got a call late one night where he said, Q, I've been listening to Stormy Weather, and I think it's one step too high. And I'd like you to transpose the band down one step, and we'll redo it in Los Angeles.
Man, just keep the shuffle just cooking, but bring down the volume, you know? And you're up at 46 in the key change.